Sean with Cool Mini or Not, he's going to show us Bloodborne.
Hey there, guys. So this is Bloodborne, and we're very, very excited about this one. It is based on the video game from Sony for the PS4, and it is designed by Eric M. Lang. So in this game, everybody takes on the role of a hunter, and we're going to be going delving into a chalice dungeon and facing a series of monsters and finally facing off against a final boss. So the idea of the game is that it is semi-cooperative. As each new monster comes up, the players are going to select an action card from their hand, and then they get revealed at the same time, and everybody will hopefully do damage against the monster, not take too much damage themselves, or possibly they will do a save action where they can bank some of the points they've accumulated along the way. So every time we face a monster, every time a monster shows up, they'll have a certain amount of what we call blood echoes. And those are your reward for doing damage against them, but also they're the points in the game. So as you do damage against them, if I did damage with my saw cleaver, well, that does one point of damage against it, and I would collect a blood echo for that. So that's how the game's going to progress. When a creature gets killed, we look at what type of creature it is, and if you had a hand in killing the creature that round or damaging the creature that round, you're going to collect a trophy of that type for that creature. So one of the key parts of this game is our health bar, and the monsters are going to attack us with one of the die along the way, and we're going to be taking damage, and throughout the course of the game, we are going to die. So you are going to lose any non-collected blood echoes if you die along the way. So that's just, you just got to be careful about that. And one way to avoid it is the Hunter's Dream. Now, this is a very important card in the game. The Hunter's Dream is kind of like a save point. And what happens with the Hunter's Dream is when you play it, you're going to take only half the damage that the monster deals that round. You're going to be able to move your collected blood echoes, everything that you have there, into your banked blood echoes slot. And those are safe for you for the rest of the game. You're also going to restore to full health, and you're going to be able to collect all of your action cards into your hand. Otherwise, you'll never get those cards back into your hand. Also, you'll be able to pick up an upgrade card. So the starting hand is a pretty weak hand, but as you go along the way, you'll be able to choose new upgraded cards to add to your hand that is going to make you better able to face the monstrous denizens of the Chalice Dungeon. So it is a semi-cooperative game in the sense that each monster that comes up, you're going to do battle with them together and try to kill them all together. However, ultimately, it is one person is going to win the game. So the person who has collected the most points through blood echoes and through trophies is going to be the only one who safely escapes the Chalice Dungeon. So very neat idea. Kind of, a dark, interesting theme that we've come to expect from Mr. Lang. And been a big hit for us at the convention. We've had stacks and stacks of it that have started like this and gone steadily down. So very excited about Bloodborne. We're glad it's such a hit for us this year.
All right, thanks a lot, Sean.
Thank you.
Like and follow us on Facebook to stay current on our show schedule, sneak peeks at future shows, and interact with us.